الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. وبعد، a hot topic these days among Muslims. I mean non-Muslims, that's what can I say? Among Muslims. Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, Wahhabis. Here is a segment of the biography and mission of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed me to author in more than 580 pages, containing more than 1500 footnotes. The resources are more than 300, a half of them, or almost a half of them, from Western resources. This book took me 10 months to produce, Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal. We made research. I went to the biggest library in the world, the Library of Congress, stayed there for days, took out hundreds of books, literally made copies, stayed in Washington DC for days until I finished. The last thing we do is brush aside anything. We don't brush aside anything. I don't have a brush except the one I use for my, not significant, hair and my beard, that's all. But we don't brush aside anything. These days, strangely enough, people who claim that they are Salafi attacking Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab with regards to the da'wah. Let's remind everyone, what's the da'wah of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab? A call back to Tawheed, a call against shirk, and a call to go back to the Quran and Sunnah and the way of the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the da'wah of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. And the munafiqeen of today, the hypocrites, throw in names. Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, Imam al-Shawkani criticized Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. Alhamdulillah, we put out videos and at least 8 articles refuting what they're saying about al-Shawkani. In fact, he was praising Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, calling him al-Allama. And they're saying Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab killed Muslims. You know, those who invoke the dead, they're not mushrik. It is shirk, but in their case, because they're ignorant, it's a bid'ah at a minimum. Or they actually call for invoking the dead as a part of the religion. Subhanallah. So they attack Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. They say, this scholar said this about him, that scholar. And one of them, who used to say the exact opposite of what he's saying now, I mean, it's looked like two personalities, one saying things and this guy refuting the things that this personality said. It's strange. I have no idea what kind of medicine they need, medication, but it is strange. So the man, this personality, said that there is a fake book ascribed to the brother of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab criticizing the Wahhabi da'wah. Okay, we spoke about that in another video. Now he brings that book and says, look, this is the book written by the brother of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab criticizing the da'wah. Here he says it's fake, denounce it, says we can't use fabricated evidence against Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. And here he says, read the book. This man called Muslims kuffar. He was killing Muslims. He's a takfiri. We used as evidence in this book resources of all types, including from the fake resources. See, one brother, I have no idea what some brothers sometimes are saying. Did you read this book when you wrote a biography? I said, why do I have to read it? See my question here? Someone who makes research for tens of years, and someone who I doubt wrote even one paragraph about anything religious in Islam or made any research of any type. Did you read this book and that book? I said, why should I read the books you're mentioning? Why? So you brushed them aside. This was a year and a half ago, or maybe more. This is, I think this was before COVID. After COVID, just recently, somebody's attacking me saying he brushed aside these books. I don't have a brush that size. I don't have a brush that size. We read these references you're talking about. I read the book about the history of Najd, I think before I had a full beard, way before. You think we didn't read about this? Also, why? Why should we read books criticizing Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab as if somebody writing a book criticizing anyone, including Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, Aisha, as if writing a book criticizing them is evidence? It's not evidence, Habibi. Let me correct that. It's not one Habibi. Habibis, this is not evidence. Evidence is in the Quran and Sunnah. Bring ayat, bring a hadith. Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab called to Tawheed. Bring evidence that shirk is okay. I mean, how can you contradict him? I don't understand. So, of course, we didn't brush aside. I mean, from the resources I just mentioned, are these fake books? I mentioned them, mentioned their stories and some stuff they said. Don't you think that you're the one who should be reading and not brushing aside this book about Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab to satisfy the rage in your heart against a man whose crime is to call you to the Quran and Sunnah? I can't understand it. Why all this aggressive behavior against Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab? Page 499 and 500, I have this topic: scholars who were impressed by the da'wah of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. An impressive list of scholars embraced and supported, or at least praised, the reformist da'wah of Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. Among them was the Yemeni scholar of Sunnah, Al-Amir Prince Muhammad ibn Ismail al-San'ani, who wrote Subul al-Salam. We study Subul al-Salam. A famous book on Islamic law. The same law that Hamza Yusuf is making fun of, and Yasser Qadhi says it wasn't really meant, but a threat. MashaAllah. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. This ayah could be, according to the system that Yasser Qadhi came out with from Yale, could be among the holes in the documentation of the Quran. It came in out of nowhere. لا إله إلا الله. As-San'ani recited a poem about Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab praising his efforts to purify acts of worship and dedicate them to Allah alone, and to reject all types of innovation in the religion and superstition. Imam al-San'ani. This is the fact. The joke. Recently, Yasser Qadhi and others throwing names, say, well, he was a takfiri, no evidence. He killed Muslims, called all Muslims kuffar, no evidence. He did this, no evidence, nothing. Just keep talking, throwing names that most Muslims have no idea who they are. So the audience is listening, ah, Imam al-San'ani removed the poem he said praising Tawheed and rejecting Shirk and saying that this is the mission of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, and brought back another one saying what? Praising Shirk and calling against Tawheed? I mean, think, you people, think. He is praising the da'wah of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab as the da'wah that calls to Tawheed and against Shirk. He removed that poem and brought another one saying what? Saying what? Shirk is okay, Tawheed is no good. What's wrong with you people? Plus, this is fake. This is a lie. Kadib, the one who says it is a kadhab, it's fake. Any other words? Fabricated, not true, no good, not good. I could use also no good, not good, as two separate words or statements. It's kadhib. It doesn't exist. Where is the evidence? From a reliable source, not from a liar. Don't go to a Shia and bring a book about Umar ibn Khattab and say, well, look what he said about Umar. We thought Umar was good. Look what these people are saying about Umar. Don't brush it aside. There is no evidence. It's just a fake information about Imam al-San'ani. Imam al-San'ani was a Salafi, a Muwahid. And Jazahullahu Khayran, he said the truth about Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, never removed it or reversed it. There is no way. Where is the evidence? Another name they throw is Imam al-Shawkani. Again, most Muslims, including Arab Muslims, have no idea who al-Shawkani is. They might have heard about him. Who's al-Shawkani? Who's al-San'ani? So many of them don't even know Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. They hear the word Wahhabi, but they don't really know. So he said this, he did that, he said kafir, he called Muslim, he killed Muslim, blah, blah, blah. San'ani, Shawkani. We have 8 articles that we recently posted. We have a long interview with the brothers at One Da'wah, may Allah reward them. We spoke about the lie that al-Shawkani, we spoke about the lie that Imam al-Shawkani criticized the da'wah of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab and called him a takfiri, and he's doing that. What we brought is actually exactly what Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab said. And I challenge the people, say, you called Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab a takfiri, a khawarij? Well, al-Shawkani said the same thing. He said, those who invoke the dead for help are committing shirk, and the only judgment they deserve is a saif, the sword. Of course, the Islamic State only does this, not for groups and whatever. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us knowledge in the religion. So Imam al-Shawkani, let's talk about him here. Imam al-Shawkani, Muhammad ibn Ali al-Shawkani, who died in 1824, one of the major scholars of Sunnah, a Salafi, was also a contemporary of Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. Imam al-Shawkani wrote a book titled Nail al-Awtar, this on fiqh, a major reference on Islamic law. We used to teach from that book. And many other books, including several booklets against polytheism, shirk practices, popular during his time. Al-Shawkani wrote an emotional poem when he heard of Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab's death. He praised his efforts in resurrecting knowledge of Tawheed and rejecting practices of shirk and bid'ah. In his poem, Ash-Shawkani affirmed that Ibn Abdul Wahhab only called to the Quran and Sunnah and to truth. Since the books Imam Ash-Shawkani wrote are still major references available throughout the Muslim world, again, most Muslims have no idea who this man is, it should be another indication that the da'wah of Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab is a pure da'wah and a reformist movement based strictly on the original resources and teachings of Islam. On hearing of Ibn Abdul Wahhab's death, Shaykh Hussein ibn Ghannam al-Ahsa'i from al-Ahsa', which is in Eastern Arabia, in Eastern Saudi Arabia of today, wrote an emotional poem describing his grief at the Shaykh's death. He also described the Shaykh's da'wah and attested that it was a resurrection of Tawheed in its purest form. Shaykh Hussein ibn Ghannam is the author of Rawdat al-Afkar wal-Afham, also known as Tariq Najd. Again, I used to read this book way before. Then brush it aside. I read it. I read parts and parts and parts and parts over the span of years. Several other scholars and sheikhs wrote poems about Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, such as Sheikh Imran ibn Ali ibn Radwan from Persia, a Sunni, of course, a Muslim, Abu al-Samh Abdud al-Dhafir al-Misri from Misr. He was a former Imam of Mecca's Grand Masjid. Sheikh Ahmad ibn Musharraf al-Ahsa'i from al-Ahsa'. In addition, various biographies of Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab were authored by renowned scholars, linguists, and noted personalities of our time. We should state that the most authoritative scholars of Hadith and Sunnah of our time were equally impressed by the da'wah of Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. They include, listen, now these are scholars, these are imams, these are the imams of the Salafi da'wah, the callers to Tawheed. They include Imam Abdul Aziz ibn Abdullah ibn Baz, Muhammad Nasir al-Din al-Albani, Muhammad ibn Salih al-Uthaymeen, and Muqbil ibn Hadi al-Wadi'i. May Allah forgive them and give them His mercy, all of them. And so many other scholars who are their teachers, who are their students, and they are scholars in their own right. Those who embrace the call of Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab exist today in every part of the Muslim world. It's not possible for someone who says he's a Salafi to criticize the da'wah of Imam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. Not the fiqh fatawa, the da'wah. His books are available in many languages, and his efforts to resurrect knowledge of Islam and the Sunnah is remembered and appreciated by Muslims. For example, I challenge again and again and again all those who attack Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. Bring a kitaba at-tawheed. Okay, bring Kitab al-Tawheed by Muhammad ibn, the most famous book. Kitab al-Tawheed, chapters, title, ayat, ahadith. And refute them. Don't say there are holes in the documentation of the Quran. Islamic law was meant as a threat. Don't sit next to Habib al-Jafri and say, ومن جودك فإن من جودك الدنيا وضرتها ومن علومك علم اللوح والقلم. Say about Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, from a part of your generosity is this life. You gave us this life. And ضرتها الآخرة. A part of your knowledge is the knowledge found in اللوح and written by القلم. لا إله إلا الله. What did you leave for Allah? It is time for the Muslim youth of today to start learning their great history and appreciating their leaders and scholars. As for non-Muslims who read this book, it is an opportunity for them to appreciate Islam and realize that it is a magnificent religion, astoundingly complex yet easy to understand and abide by. It is not a cult of some sort. It is a dynamic religion with a set of rules that define its creed and law. The magnificence of Islam's creed takes strength from its clarity and the availability of its original resources, as fresh as the day they were revealed. So this is a part of the biography and mission of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. Throwing in names that people have no idea who they are. San'ani, Shawkani, no references. So they praised the call to Tawheed and against Shirk, and then they reversed. They started calling to Shirk and against Tawheed. What's wrong with you people? Think before you take any fake statement. And the brother of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, he wrote a book against it. So that doesn't mean what he wrote, if that's true, makes Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab's da'wah wrong just because his brother objected to it, and his father, maybe his whole tribe. What's wrong with you? That's evidence? That's not evidence. You mean Abu Lahab rejecting Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and going after him in every station in Mecca where he went to, people who residing, coming for Hajj or Umrah, calling them to Islam? Don't listen to this man. He's my nephew. I know him very well. You know, he's a liar. Is that proof against Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? What's wrong with this? I have no idea. I don't understand. So throwing names without references, using fake books. Can you believe that the brother of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab resided in the same city of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab and Muhammad bin Saud? The people they accuse of being takfiris, people who killed Muslims, called Muslims kuffar, he's sitting there in the same town, writing a book, rejecting the da'wah of Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab and calling it a da'wah al-Wahhabiyya? Are you crazy? Stop insulting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is al-Wahhab. Allah is al-Wahhab. If you say this came from Allah al-Wahhab, you should praise them. And stop insulting Allah. Allah is al-Wahhab. There is no da'wah Wahhabiyya. The Brits came up with this decades after Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab died and his brother. So his brother couldn't have written about the da'wah Wahhabiyya, trying to what? Defame his father? Supposedly his father was with him against Muhammad. What's wrong with the people today? Wallah, I have no idea. I have no idea. They don't think, and they are criticizing, defaming, slandering an imam of Islam whose crime is to call them to Tawheed and against Shirk. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us knowledge in the religion and make us straight on the path of Tawheed and against the path of Shirk. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.